as there's Lex Luger that he's challenging for the NWA Florida Heavyweight title held by Danny Doering. And there you see Florida legend and former NWA World Heavyweight Champion for over 4.5 years, Dory Funk Jr., refereeing this match. Quite an honor for the guys in the ring. Wake up, Frankie.
Huh.
Wake up.
Oh, wow. Did you say Danny Doering?
Yes, I said Danny Doering, I said Dory Funk Jr., I said Lex Lovett, and I believe I had the word it in there somewhere.
Lex Lovett, Cabana Boy number 14, and Danny Doering. I tell you what, Danny Doering, another consummate professional, just like Steve Corino and many of the guys that came out of the defunct, now defunct, ECW. And this Danny Doering's been traveling all over the country, all over the world, traveling to England, Japan, back here in the country, still making a name for himself and still making a living in the ring where he made the name for himself. Forget that. Aaron, take this over.
Frankie Capone, you're like Ron Nini here, spewing over your words. You think you had the tequisas before you came in this week, but it was actually probably a blue sky. But let me tell you, Danny Doering, I don't care what anybody says, I think he's better now than he was in ECW. He's in better shape. He seems to know what he's doing more in the ring. He's more comfortable as a veteran. And the NWA Florida Heavyweight title has always been a stepping stone to the NWA World Heavyweight title that's currently held by Jeff Jarrett, at least as of this taping. So hopefully Danny Doering will get a shot at that title in the very near future and make all of us down here in Florida very, very proud.
You know what, Aaron? I have no doubt in my mind that Danny Doering, any day of the week, could put Jeff Jarrett away, hands down. And he's not going to have any trouble at all putting Cabana Boy number 72 down for the three count tonight for the NWA Florida title.
It's amazing. Lex Lovett is rising in this sport so fast. His Cabana Boy number keeps going up by the minute as we're doing this commentary. And then a nice clothesline there by Danny Doering as he gets up. And he's working over Lex Lovett in a way I've never really seen anybody do here before. He's fired up. Lex Lovett, a former NWA World Junior Heavyweight Champion. So he's got some NWA heritage there as well. And he's out here with Jimmy Del Rey. And we saw here last week that these guys, they attack their buddy, their partner. What is that?
That looks like the thong that Cannon wears on Friday nights.
It's got bells on it.
He's got bells on his brush hole.
That's got to be a present from SoCal Val, a Christmas present. You see her there outside the ring. He was bragging about it in the back, and he tried to show all of us. And we just said, no, thank you, brother. This isn't that kind of locker room.
I think I'm going to pee my pants.
And here goes Lex Love. He's pulled a table out, thinking he's a Dudley Boy or Sabu or Public Enemy or something of that nature, trying to say, hey, Danny Doering, while you were in ECW, I watched it on television, so I know what's going on here. But like I said, last week these guys attacked Steve Madison, the big man on campus. He's now in the camp of Ron Nimi and 911 Incorporated, and you've got to wonder if that will come into play sometime during this match.
Well, Cabana Boy number 92, Lex Lovett, going for the powerbomb on the table to Danny Doering. Whoa, pile driver, excuse me. Danny Doering blocking a consummate professional, backdrop into the ring. He should have actually backdropped him on that table. That's what I would have done. But here he goes, going for the suplex. Suplex on the table, no way. Blocked by Cabana Boy 102.
You're killing me with the Cabana Boy references here, Frankie. Let's try to call the match. And there you see Lex Lovett. He gets the suplex of his own, avoids that table. Okay, that's not normally something that you'd see Dory Funk Jr. even allow. But I guess he knows he's here in the new NWA Florida. He's here in IPW. Those kind of rules that happened back in the day, they don't exist anymore. Fans want action. Fans want excitement. And we give it to them here each and every week on Recap. We give it to them each and every time we're out at the arenas.
Let me tell you something, Dory Funk officiating this match with flair and fire. If you look how quick he got down to give Cabana Boy number 232 that 3-4-5 count, he got down there with the quickness of Rey Mysterio Jr.
Actually, I was going to say, he'd make Bronco Lubitsch very, very proud.
Bronco Lubitsch was one of my favorite referees back in 1981 when he was officiating down there in Texas at the Sportatorium. But enough about that. Danny Doering better watch out for this chair shot by Cabana Boy number 329. What's his name again? Terry Funk?
No, that's Terry's brother, Dory Funk Jr.
Dory Funk, Terry Funk, Jimmy Jack Funk, it makes no difference to me how many Funks there are. But Danny Doering going after the chair himself. You know, stranger, that's it. He is no stranger to the chair shots. And if you look here, going for the suplex by Danny Doering, Florida NWA champion. Where's he going?
I don't know where he's going. He should have gone for the 1-2-3 right there. Oh, and he goes, okay, Lex, I'll show you how tables really work. I was actually in ECW. I know what's going on here, brother. And there's SoCal Valley again.
How do you know what these guys are saying, Aaron?
Because I'm just that damn good. That's why, Frankie Capone. There's a reason I'm on here each and every week. There's a reason that they're trying to weed out guys like Ron Nimi and bring me in colorful guys like yourself and Rod Steele so that I can shine the way I was meant to shine. And I choose to shine.
Look at this Irish whip. Reversal, he reverses it right into the chair that Danny Doring set up for himself. Right into the chair. Oh. The table. The table he broke.
Lex Lovett, no slouch. He's played possum. He set Danny Doring up very, very well. There you see his trainer, Jimmy Del Rey, out there. Very, very proud of his man. We've been talking about Lex Lovett, about Danny Doring so much that we're forgetting Lex Lovett. This guy, a former Florida champion, a former world champion as far as NWA is concerned.
You know what, Lex Lovett, you know, we have been ignoring a little flip that he doodah, making 0-2 driver there by Lex Lovett. He is no stranger to the squared circle, and he's giving Danny Doring a run for his money here for that NWA Florida title. And you know what, I may have to change my bet. You know what, I don't win many bets in Vegas, Aaron, if you know what I'm talking about. But Lex Lovett may have it in the bag here. He's going up to the top rope. SoCal Val, doing exactly what she needs to do in that standing behind her man.
Jimmy Del Rey comes and puts him into that really quickly. And what's he? Oh, now he throws
I'm sure he has
ring.
No problem grabbing
Larry Funk, if you're going to be a referee, for crying out loud, do something.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. The flare and the fire of Dory Funk. Look at this. Beautiful. Now, see, this is uncalled for. She's a lady.
Now, here comes Danny Doring. Oh, this should be it. There, come on, get him up. Bareback.
You got to be kidding me. Would he steal that move from me, too?
Everybody steals from you, Frankie.
You got to be kidding
me. Three, finally, still your NWA Florida Heavyweight Champion, Danny Doring.
Ladies and gentlemen, you will fall in the match.